Hello everyone. So after getting a dishwasher, the next thing on our list was obviously something that could clean the house. And most vacuum cleaners make a lot of noise and you have to hold it and move with it. So we zeroed in on some automatic cleaners. A lot of automatic cleaners available in the market. We zeroed on Eufy Robovac G10 Hybrid. It's a very compact cleaner, as you can see, not heavy, and it cleans very well. So I found it very convenient. It isn't noisy, does a very good job with everyday cleaning, and it comes with a completely Chinese manual. So we had to figure it out ourselves about setting up the device, and even the built-in voice was Chinese. So we had to change the inbuilt voice to English by the Eufy Home app, and this is mostly app operated, but you can also pair it with Alexa and Google and command it from that. I'm going to put up the links from where I bought this and the other parts in the description. So let's get started with a small demo or review. I've been using it for a week now, so let's start. We have a stairs here. Just see how it very smartly turns and goes. It does not fall from the stair. Right now we have not used the mop. We are only doing the jhadu or the dusting. See again. We were actually scared about this bit, but this one's a smart robot. It just goes. And there's a pile of kachda over there, all dust. See, it's grabbing all of it. You can see it has just pulled up all that pile. We've paused it. Now we'll mop. This is an attachment, a small tank sort of a thing where you can fill water. It's a pretty small one, doesn't take too much water, maybe half a mug or something. And there is a Velcro, and these two, this and this, these are the water outlets from where the water comes out. This is the cloth, it also has the Velcro, and it's very easy to fix here, but it needs a little bit of capillary action. You have to wet it a bit sometimes, so it can, that is when it works well, because we've tried using without wetting it and on those days the mopping just didn't happen. So now we wet it a little bit and this is how you can just easily put it inside. It's very smooth, and fix the Velcro. It is washable and very easy to use. Let's see how we fix it here in the machine.
It just goes from here and fixes itself. Just that tick sound will come and you know it is locked. Now you can start. Usually goes in the U direction, lane by lane. Here we've started it. Here you can see, it's wet, so it is mopping. Because of its round shape, corners can be a tough task. It doesn't reach all the corners. And sometimes it needs guidance to be told where it has to go in the room. Sometimes it gets stuck also. It actually enters under most of the furniture that is 3 inch and above, like slightly higher than its size. For others, it either doesn't enter or it gets stuck, so you have to guide him. Tell this little boy that if he has to take another turn. We often block the rooms. Like here, we've closed the door of the bedroom so that it does not enter that. It just cleans this area first and then we'll start with the bedroom again and finish that area. The manual says that you have to use only plain water, so right now we are not using any Lysol or any other disinfectant, we are only using water. So we have to probably clean once in a week or so by our own selves, because it does pretty good job of cleaning and mopping. Now it's the test. Let's see if it can take out this color that my kids have spilled. Sometimes if it doesn't clean in the regular cleaning strokes, there's a spot cleaning system where it cleans in the circular manner, starting from a spot and increasing its circumference in a circular manner over that spot. So I'll show you that as well in a while. You can see this area is actually cleaner now. It has mopped. Now because it did not clean this paint stain, I'll show you a spot cleaning video. Here we are going to start the spot cleaning.
Start spot cleaning.
It's going in a circular manner and keeps going, increases its radius. There you are, the big splash of color has gone. There you are, the entire color spot has gone, looking nice and clean. Now let me show you how to take out that mop tank. There's a button underneath, you just have to press it a little bit like this and it comes out very easily. So the tank is out from here. From here you just press and see. This is the dustbin that has come out. Let's see how much it has collected. Oh my god. It has just picked up all sorts of kachra that it could. Oh god. This place was so dirty. The house is particularly dirty today. It's not this dirty every time, but it was closed for over a week, and so, and here are the filters that you can take out and clean very lightly with a brush, not with water. Dry brush very lightly because it is made of paper. Soft they are. Here you can see this. These are like HEPA filters. So you can take a close look at them. This is how you take out the filters. Take them out. They're full of all the dust. And you fix it from here and take it out from here like this. Like this, you just fix it. And the same way, you just take it out like that. Here. They have provided this brush with which you can easily clean. Don't put too much pressure because the filters might get damaged. You can even blow air and clean it. Some like this also you can do. And it's clean. They've given an extra filter as well. With the set, we've ordered extra filters from AliExpress. You can obviously get it from Indian online stores as well, but it was costlier, way costlier. So in AliExpress we've got it at a cheaper rate and we've ordered 4 filters. Starting with the kitchen, the dirtiest I guess in the whole house, with lots of dust and peels and stains. So we're starting with a circular motion first, the spot cleaning one. It actually does the mopping and dusting together, but after a few trials we thought we'd do dusting alone first and then we'd put the mop. That way it cleans better. Now we're starting the U-shape regular cleaning. So try to keep it in one corner from where it can straight come and take a U-turn and go parallelly to the other side. We'll show you how it does. There. Step by step it will clean. We've tried putting it in several spots, but this starting from the corner thing works best because it covers maximum area in that way. So right now it is still sweeping and then it will mop. You can also notice that it is not very noisy. Like an usual vacuum cleaner, it doesn't make too much noise. It's very quiet. We often do start with the cleaning early in the morning. Even when the kids are asleep, they won't get disturbed.
Awesome.
Now we are starting with the mopping. This is the wet mopping. That is how we mostly block its way, so that it just covers one room at a time. It runs for around 90 minutes at one go, and then you will have to charge the batteries again. If it discharges in between, it will go back to its charging point on its own. And you can see in this the wet patch, how it's cleaning and how it's removing most of the stains. For all the stains that it doesn't remove in just the mopping, we do the spot cleaning, and most of the stains do get cleaned in that. So for day-to-day cleaning, this works perfectly well. For extensive cleaning, probably you'll have to do it manually. This is the app, Eufy Home. You press it there. You get your home screen. And here is how you do the applications. Clean, recharge, schedule. You can schedule like every day at 7 a.m. or every Sunday, every Monday. It has time slots. So you can do a schedule as well. This is the suction levels, and it is probably done at the max and we can't change it. Here's the spot cleaning function. I'll show you how we do it. We'll first pick it up and put it at the spot we require. Yeah, and now we'll go here and we'll click on spot. And then it starts spot cleaning. You can see that the spot over here is cleaned. There was a dirty spot there. Sometimes if there's too much furniture where it can't go under, it gets confused and you will have to supervise it a little bit. So you will have to play a little bit with this and figure out what spot works for you for the cleaning, and from where it can cover the maximum area. So for us, it is the corner. The corners works best. We started from the corner and it covers most of the parts. And also, because it doesn't have a mapping function, we have to use the spot cleaning and we have to do the placing properly. There are others that do have a mapping function. This one doesn't have mapping function, but it's still easy, because if you remove some big furniture and start from the corner, it covers all the areas possible. This is the power adapter. You plug it in. This is the charging station. Let me show you. This is how it looks. And this is some drying pad. I suggest you always keep the tank empty when it is charging or it is just lying idle, so that it doesn't keep dripping water. And you can take out that cloth and wash it and dry it. Meanwhile, it charges. Now I'll show you, once you're done cleaning, you can give a home command. to the machine and it goes back to its home. We've kept our charging station under our TV unit, which is very convenient. It doesn't take space. Now I'll show you how we do the recharge button. We click it. It says heading home. And see, by itself it's just going home. Now it's charging. It takes around 3 to 4 hours to completely charge. That blinking light will become blue and you'll know it is charged. In the app right now, you can see right now it is also showing charging. Once it's charged, it will show standby and charged. There's another function that says find. So let's see what does. It finds your robot wherever it is. Here we've clicked on start. And it is saying Robovac is on the charging base. It just tells you where your little robot is. So here are some tips in the app itself. And it says that mopping mode is not recommended when no one is at home. Because what if it's stuck and it's leaking and you wouldn't know. The second is only use the mopping mode on the floor without carpets. Because it is wet and it will be an issue if the carpets are wet. It won't clean the carpets. It's not like the vacuum cleaner. So you can use without the tank on the carpets or on your huge sofas or whatever. It'll just clean the dust. And you should always remove the water tank when Robovac is under charging or not in use. And before mopping, install the waterproof pad under the charging base that I showed you a while before. So these are the tips that you should keep in your mind. Here is the on-off button. This is the on and off button. So these are the fans. They're made of nylon fans or brush or the dusting that you can call. They're consumables and you will have to order if they're destroyed. They've given two sets of these fans or these brushes are already given. You might have to order more. I'll provide the links in the description box. You can easily pull it out from the socket. I'll show you how. Yeah. You can press and fix it again. These are the sensors. 1, 2, 3. You have to clean them. These are the charging pads. This is where it connects to charge. Here is the battery. This is the suction place. This is where it pulls in all the dust.
So, as a gist of this whole demo or review, I'd say the pros, according to me, are it cleans well. And mopping is obviously a very useful function. It doesn't make noise and is automatic, obviously. It's very easy to operate, consumes less water, and is cheaper than its competitors. The cons, I would say, is that it may not reach all the corners because of its round shape, and some tough stains might require manual cleaning. But as you saw in the video, it actually cleans some of the tough paint stains and all that. So it may vary. You might not require any manual cleaning also for all the stains. And another thing is, it doesn't have the mapping function. So you have to guide it sometimes and be there to see if it's getting stuck or all those things. So monitoring is required. I hope you enjoyed this little demo come review of the Eufy Robovac G10 Hybrid. And do like this video, subscribe to our channel, and if you have any other suggestions or questions, do write in the comments box. See you again. We have many more videos, so subscribe and be here on this channel. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.